Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how you can go back to Windows 10 from Windows 11 if your computer has recently upgraded to Windows 11 from Windows 10. Starting from your Windows 11 desktop, right-click on your Start button and then select Settings. Once you're on the Windows 11 Settings screen, go to the Windows Update tab here on the left. Then you want to scroll all the way down until you find the Advanced Options tab and then click on that. And in the Advanced Options, you want to scroll down until you find the Recovery tab and then click on that. And then in the Recovery Options section, you'll have this option where it says Go Back. If this version isn't working, try going back to Windows 10. And you'll only see this option if you've upgraded from Windows 10 to Windows 11 in the past 10 days. After that, this option will not be available anymore. But to go back to Windows 10 using this option, you can go ahead and click on Go Back. You'll be prompted to give a reason why you're going back to Windows 10, and you can choose any one of these options. I'm just going to choose for another reason and then click on Next. You'll be prompted to check for updates before you go back, so you can try and fix the problems you might be having in Windows 11. We're not having any problems, we just want to go back to Windows 10. So just click on No Thanks. And then you'll see the screen that says what you need to know, and it'll give you a summary of what's about to change. And on this screen, it says you'll have to reinstall some apps and programs, and you'll lose any changes made to settings after the upgrade to Windows 11. It's always a good idea to have a backup of your files. So before going back to Windows 10, just make sure you do have a backup of your most important files. But once you're ready, just go ahead and click on Next. And lastly, make sure you have the password that you used to sign into Windows 10 if you did have a password. And that should also be the same password you used to sign into Windows 11 if you used the password to sign into your account on Windows. When you're ready, just go ahead and click on Next. On this last screen that says thanks for trying Windows 11, you can just go ahead and click on Go Back to Windows 10 to start the process of reversing the Windows 11 upgrade. Now, this downgrade process can take anywhere from around 30 minutes to an hour, depending on if you have a solid state drive or hard drive in your computer, and your computer will restart a few times during the downgrade process. But once it's finished, you'll be taken back to your Windows 10 installation, and you might be prompted with some more prompts trying to get you to go back to Windows 11 again or to install or upgrade to Windows 11. You can just skip those and stay on Windows 10, and then you'll be taken to your Windows 10 desktop. I do hope this guide helped you out. Please like the video and watch any of my other helpful videos that's linked on the screen now. I'll see you in the next one.